Along with Creations, Starfield just released its first paid content, and should you be upset about it? What's it like? We're going to review the Trackers Alliance mission, part one, in this video. Welcome to Starfield Signal, your place for all things Starfield. I'm your host, Signal, and today we're talking about the Trackers Alliance. I'm going to save my final thoughts for the end, but I do want to give you just kind of a few rundown pieces before we get into my final thoughts and what I'm going to suggest for you. So be sure to stay tuned to the end of the video for that. First thing is I want to talk about my expectations for this. When I first saw that the Vulture, which is the second part of the Trackers Alliance mission, or maybe that's not a fair statement, it's the second available mission from the Trackers Alliance. Maybe that's a better way to put it. The first one is free. It came with the June update, and so if you want to check out the Trackers Alliance, see what all the fuss is about and get your feet wet in that, it's completely free. It's included in the June update. It is live now on Xbox Series and PC. So my expectations going into this, when I saw, okay, first part's free, second part's paid, I was thinking, okay, if part of this is paid, then these missions have to be, right? They have to be a little meatier. They have to be a bit more complex. They have to have some more kind of gravity to them as far as the weight of the story, the weight of the mission, the implications that may have on your play style, with weapons you may get, with your companion relationships. Surely this is more than just the typical bounty missions we've been able to get through, like, the other mission boards, right? Right? A little foreshadowing. Channeling my inner H bomber guy here. And so those were my expectations going in. And it's not like I expected, you know, something to, for this to be like a 5-hour long quest line that was just mind-blowing. I was saving that for, you know, expecting that from Shattered Space. But I was expecting a good, solid 2 hours. 2 hours of gameplay, going around to some different locations, the mission leading me in different areas, maybe encountering some new enemy types, or at least some enemies with some new weapons to make it a bit more challenging. And we got a little bit of that. We'll get into that. But I think what we ended up getting was a little less, maybe a lot less, depending on your perspective of it, than what I was anticipating. But I'll save more of those thoughts for the end of the video. Let's get into what actually happens in the Trackers Alliance first mission. So the first mission in the Trackers Alliance is called the Starjacker, and you are tracking down a wanted and known hijacker of starships. And said, I forget the number they said, but it was quite a bit. It was quite a bit of starships that this guy was accused, you know, had allegedly taken from different starports and things like that. So you're charged with tracking this guy down, and during kind of the intro missions, they say several times, your NPCs say several times, like, hey, we're going to walk you through this first one, but everything after this, you're kind of on your own. And so I was expecting something a bit more complicated, a bit more complex, something where you're going to have to do more with your scanner, something where you're going to have to actually look and read through some documentation on or hear some audio clips that you're going to have to piece together and kind of figure out, how do I track this guy? Maybe go talk to his known associates. Maybe go to old bases and see if you can track down some hints. So I'm expecting, you know, a solid quest line here. And what you start out with is, you do start with a little bit of that. So you start out with them kind of telling you how to locate your bounty. And they send you out. You're right in Aquila City. You stay there and you turn on your scanner, and it says, hey, if you find your bounty, they're going to be kind of highlighted in red. Simple enough. I did this part 3 to 4 different times just for recording content and all that stuff. The first 3 times, I think, was really easy. Just went out to the Aquila City kind of hub there, right in the main street, if you want to say that, right out in front of the rock. And I looked around for a couple minutes and eventually saw the guy walking down the steps. And I was like, okay, here he is. So it wasn't too hard to find him. All of those times, it kind of worked out the same. He eventually ended up at the same location every time. The fourth time I did it, I think I was actually on a stream when I did this, but I could not find the guy. Looked everywhere around Aquila City, looked around the main street, looked in the slums, looked around the other parts there, and could not find him. Eventually ended up going up into orbit, coming back down to Aquila City to reload everything. I figured maybe his tracking got off, maybe he was stuck in some sort of wall, maybe his script didn't initiate something weird, or maybe I was just missing him. That's a possibility too. But anyway, after I did that, as soon as I walked into Aquila City, saw the guy right by the rock, was able to initiate the quest line. And so if that is a bug, then if you're not able to find your target on this first one, be sure to reload the area somehow, either quick save and reload a save, or go back up into orbit, come back down, let Aquila City reload, and hopefully that will help you if you're having the same problem that I encountered. And then after you talk to this guy, he says, like, hey, I'm not the guy you're looking for, and you know that going into it, but and don't worry, I'm not going to spoil the end of it, because there's kind of a little twist at the end of this, which is interesting. I'm not going to spoil that, he sends you on kind of this, what ends up being a little bit of a wild goose chase, but it's fun. You go into this, an abandoned star yard, I think, and they've kind of turned it into a chop shop, where they're taking apart all these starships that they've starjacked, and they're taking them apart. So it's a really cool idea. It's a really cool environment. It's zero grav, zero gravity whenever you're in this encounter. And so I didn't encounter a ton of those in just, you know, the regular missions in Starfield proper. So it was neat to get some more experience with that. And there wasn't a ton of enemies in here. It was mostly, like, it wasn't heavily fortified or anything like that. And there was a little bit of kind of, again, like a little goose chase, like, hey, you got to go find this key, then you have to open up the starship, and then you have to activate a missile launcher to blast through a door. And so I appreciated that. Just kind of the beats were a bit more complex, a bit more storytelling involved there than just the typical go into an encounter, a location, a POI that you've already been 100 times, and then go to the end of it, which you already know how to get there with your eyes closed at this point, and then kill the hardest guy there. So it was a bit more complicated than that, which I appreciated. I think they can still work on that. Not necessarily building the complexity, but just kind of building the drama around it. Have some more NPCs with, you know, that aren't so generic. Maybe some that he's got a few henchmen that are his trained, you know, bodyguards, and there it's kind of almost like a mini boss type thing. I would love to see more of that type of structure in Starfield. So you got the boss of the dungeon, and then you have maybe some mini bosses along the way that give you trouble, or that you have to do some sort of puzzle, finding keys and unlocking doors as, you know, a huge mech is chasing you around and you can't defeat it yet because it's got some sort of shielding on it. You got to figure out how to get into this lab to get the anti-shielding gun. I don't know, I'm spitballing here, but you see what I'm talking about. Just something a bit more complex, a bit more complicated, that with a little bit of thought, a little bit of work, I think they could really make some of this stuff come alive. That would be cool. Continuing on, you eventually kind of find the guy you're looking for in here, and the story starts to kind of unfold. Again, I'm not going to spoil this, but there was a twist where I thought, oh, this is really interesting. Because it kind of seemed like the mission was coming to an end, and then, like, you're like, oh, it's not going to end. It is going to be more involved, and I am going to have to chase this guy across several systems, and I am going to have to figure out, okay, where did he go, and how did he get there, and who can I find to tell me more information? But then it just ended. It's like it was almost there. It was almost there, and so I'm not sure if there is some sort of through line or through narrative that will continue in the actual paid DLC, the Tracker's Alliance, the Vulture. I'm unsure if that's the case or if, no, that one's just over. The Starjacker's just over. You're never going to see that guy again or hear from him again. It's just over. If it is, then if they, you know, release that as free as a part of the June update to tease what the Tracker's Alliance could be, it's a bad tease. Like, they were almost there. I feel like that's the story of Starfield. Almost, for a lot of people. I love it. I love Starfield. But there are several things like, oh, you were almost there. It could have been so good. So it's still kind of yet to be determined. But from what I've experienced right now, I would not, based on the first Tracker's Alliance, like a bounty mission proper, I would not suggest to spend 700 credits on the second one, the Vulture. That may change. I am going to get it for content purposes. And I may even actually just stream that and then do a follow-up review video on it. So I'll try to make sure that I'm posting community posts and letting the community know when that will go live. But those are my final thoughts right now. I wouldn't suggest spending credits or spending money on the Tracker's Alliance, the Vulture, the second mission, but I am going to check it out, see if it expands on any of this or if it's just another mission. So that's my take on the kind of the main missions of the Tracker's Alliance. Now, again, they have their own kiosk, and so it's just like the Freestar Collective bounty mission board that you have, or some of the other, I forget which other ones give you actually like missions and bounties to go find people. You can get those there. Now, I do think maybe, and correct me if I'm wrong here, it's been so long since I've done some of the Freestar Alliance missions. One of the differences is that you can actually bring these bounties in alive through the Tracker's Alliance. If you use an electromagnetic weapon to stun your target and they go down, then that will actually complete that mission for you. And they say that it marks them. You don't actually do this with anything, and so it's a bit kind of like, okay, what else do I need to do? It feels a bit anticlimactic a little bit, but as soon as you stun them, the enemy goes down and it says, okay, you completed this quest, you get your credits, you get your experience, and then you just go on. I wish you had the choice to, like, okay, do you want to bring them in yourself, or do you want to just leave them here for the Tracker's Alliance people to come pick them up? I think that could be really neat. If you brought them in yourself, you would have to have a ship situated with a brig, right? And you would have to have go back and maybe escort them into the jail cell at the Tracker's Alliance. That would be really neat. So again, it was almost there. So those are my thoughts on this. I think it's a great addition to the Starfield universe. I think it's a great addition to the gameplay, to the gameplay loop. I think, you know, it's almost like its own other faction, and so you could even potentially do some story stuff where the Tracker's Alliance and the Freestar Collective are at odds, just kind of with their values and the way they think. This also introduces a few new named NPCs, which I thought was really neat. And they're not too generic from what I've seen so far. They actually have some personality. They have their own backstories. They have their own values and their own convictions. Some of them want to just bring every single one of their bounties in alive. Others like never bring their bounties in alive. They say it's more hassle than what it's worth. Just, you know, shoot them on sight, don't worry about it. And there's several others that I haven't got a chance to like talk with and hear their stories yet. But I appreciate that they did put some effort into the personalities, into these characters, so you can kind of grow these, you know, your relationships in Starfield as well. So those are my initial thoughts. If you've played it, let me know what you think in the comments below. I would love to have some more feedback on this and some more insight for the whole community, because I'm just one person and your mileage is going to vary on this. Do you think, if you've completed this, do you think that people should take a chance and buy the credits, or buy the credits to get the Vulture, the second mission in here? If you've already completed the Vulture, no spoilers, but what do you think? Do you, after completing it, do you think we should spend credits on it or spend that on plushies? what do you think? Let me know. If you wouldn't mind, like the video. I'm going to have a lot of other videos out over the coming weeks talking about, of course, the Shattered Space DLC. I haven't even talked about that yet. There's so much to go through in the June update. And then a couple more videos looking at some of the new features and new updates from the June update. Thank you so much for watching. For now, may you find wonder as you journey through the stars.